Welcome to the Serious Shift Blogcast. We have only one question. What does Serious Shift mean to you? To answer that and much more, here's your host, Dennis Mosley Williams.
Hey, good morning. This is Dennis, and welcome back to an overdue Serious Shift Blogcast, episode number 138. I've had some things on my mind I had to sort out. It's very nice to be back with you. It's a snowstorm where I live, and I'm one of those weirdos. I love a good snowstorm. Winter's my favorite season. But I'm having a cool thought for you today, and it's this. Winter tires. I want you to think about how much engineering goes into your car. Oh my goodness. It's a Mercedes-Benz. Oh my goodness, it costs all kinds of money. There's all kinds of German engineering and know-how. State-of-the-art technology, it's all amazing. But that whole car is held on the road by four contact points on the bottom of your tires, right? And those four points that touch the road, that hold the road, are probably the size of your iPhone. That's it. You've got $100,000 worth of car traveling at 60 miles per hour or 100 kilometers per hour on a slippery, wet road, and the whole damn thing is stuck on the road on four contact points as big as your cell phone. That's it. Everything is hinging on that. And it got me thinking about what a fantastic metaphor that is for our businesses. This whole great, big, beautiful business that we have poured ourselves into is riding on what? So four tires, here's the four biggest mistakes that I've seen people make over a 20-year career of helping businesses transform. Here it is. Here's the first one. You fail to appreciate that the world is a dynamic and changing place. You defend the status quo. You do everything you can to ensure that things stay the way they are. You double down on it. You don't realize that things are going to change, and as they change, so too will the sensibilities and desires of your client and where they find and look for value. That's the first big mistake you make. Okay, you double down on the status quo. The second is you fail to create anything amazing. You love it, you tell everybody you love it, but deep down inside, or not even so deep down, you know it's not that great. If at anything, it's just what's expected. It doesn't delight anybody, it doesn't surprise anybody, it doesn't capture their attention, nothing. They can get it, it's a commoditized service, it's fungible, you can find it anywhere, the exact same thing from somebody else who's willing to do it for less or easier than you. That's the second. Here's the third. You fail to get niche-oriented enough. You talk a good game about a niche market, but you're not really into it. You talk a good game, though. But again, you're more or less marketing general solutions to a general audience that has a general interest and a general need. Instead of tapping into a niche market and servicing it thoroughly and generously and knowing it and getting those people connected and talking, okay? And here's your fourth most critical error. You think like a marketer and not a human being. You just think that everybody cares about your products, and they don't. They couldn't care less about them. What they care about are the outcomes that your goods and services help them do. The reason you're always talking about goods and services, about products, features and benefits, is because somebody has told you to think like a marketer and not a human being. When I ask my clients, what do your clients care about? The answer I'm looking for isn't about your products or services. It's what do they care about, period. What's the problem they have, and how are you choosing to solve it? Generously, like a human being. Your business is a beautiful car. It is riding on four tires. Of those four tires, only a part of the tire, about this big, times four tires, is holding that whole show on the road. Don't make those four critical errors, my friends. You'll be sorry that you did. Delighted to have your attention. Thank you so much to all of you who are reaching out to me, checking in on how I was doing when you didn't see the blog for a couple of weeks. Thanks so very much. The short answer is I'm doing really, really, really well. And one of the reasons I'm doing really, really well is I've got you out there in my community. And I know that you're looking forward to hearing from me. And I'm looking forward to hearing from you and seeing you. You be well, everybody. Talk to you soon.
We hope you enjoyed the Serious Shift blogcast. We would love any suggestions, feedback on topics, ideas, or challenges that may have you feeling stuck. Also, please leave a 5-star review wherever you are enjoying this content. It helps Dennis out tremendously.